I think somebody was waiting on people.
That's not me, that's somebody up there.
Yeah, let's keep it tighter and darker.
Awesome. Spooky's good.
Quiet. I'm fixing to start calling you names. Trip over this uneven floor.
Come on in and shut the door, she asked.
I know.
Well, I didn't say lock it, I said shut it.
Oh, she is too. She's got it. Is that where they put the body?
Is that what we're...
Right up there.
Oh, yeah. Actually, we had a table a lot like this. Now, in this area was a morgue. That wall back there didn't exist. There was a lot of tables that would have been set up through here. A table a lot like this, that's a lab table, would have been in operation. Now, let me be clear, Norman Baker was never, ever a doctor. He never had any medical training. But with the people that died here, he actually liked to perform his own autopsies. He would cut them open, take out the cancerous parts, put them in jars of formaldehyde, and there were dozens of these jars.
Excellent.
In that back room where we saw the footage of the locker earlier.
Yeah.
That's where these jars were kept. Now, when he brought his patients here, we know that he brought 114 original patients here. 3 years later, when he was arrested for mail fraud, they could not find any records. When the feds came back for the records, they were gone. He must have had some very loyal staff, because we actually have no idea how many people have come through here, how many people died here, were treated here. We do know that Eureka Springs used to fill up with people who were wanting his cure.
Sure.
He made over $4 million in the time that he was here. Today, folks, that's like $60 million. He was sentenced to four years in Leavenworth, fined $4,000. He actually spent about 3.5 years in prison, and then he retired to Florida on a yacht. But can anybody guess what he died of?
Cancer.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. So, now the area where he kept the bodies is right there behind you, my nice folks. Now, that was the cooler, and when we open it, you will see there's not a lot of space in there. They kept up to 28 bodies at a time. They probably would have been stacked.
Sure.
Now, Norman Baker even went so far as to have his patients sign off on these postcards that basically read, "I'm getting better, the treatment is working, keep sending the money." This was a money operating scheme for him.
Sure.
Nobody got well here. So, what we're going to do now, since we have a nice large group, oh, by the way, this is his mugshot.
Snake.
So what we're going to do, since we have a nice large group, those of you who would like to first explore this cooler, I will let you do that. Let me go ahead and open it. Now, some people like to walk in. I'll turn on the light. They like to go in, shut the door, and then have the lights turned off. And the rest of you, I will take back to the locker room where they got the footage.
crowded.
You're supposed to tell her.
Now what?
Now, you are more than welcome to examine this locker. You can open it and really take a good look inside, examine as much as you want. There isn't anything that should set this off, but for some reason, this meter likes this area, and I don't know what it is about it. It's different every time. Sometimes it buries itself, sometimes it's a few beeps. That's natural. But let's see what this little EMF meter will do tonight.
Do what now?
Is this where the ghost hunter stood there?
Yeah.
In this doorway, wasn't it?
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm going to fly down.
Okay. And there we go. Okay, now I am going to step out of the way so you guys can have fun and take your pictures.